Hi, welcome back for video number 5. I'm going to be adding a single jump ring to these sets of 3, making 7 link stretches for a necklace. It is a paperclip chain. If you're watching this, thank you for watching. Leave a comment. So I'm going to start with these first because these are the rings from the last video and I would like to get them out of the way. So you take your open jump ring. Feed it through your set of 3 and then position the solder joints down. You want them away from the fire. So on all 3 links, you want your solder joints to be facing away from the flame. 1, 2, 3, good. Well, on this one, I would like my clean link to be the closest to the ring that I am working on. So all of my solder joints are facing down, away from the ring that I will be working on. Squeeze it together, and then line up your jump ring. So once again, double check, make sure all your solder joints are facing down. Because this jump ring is going to get hot and these are going to absorb the heat. And these 2 are still covered in flux and there's a chance they will run together. But I think they're going to be okay. Can't get that in focus. So in that case, I won't work with my third hand. I will just turn the table. OK, can't really see that. So let's move this. You'll be able to see that now. So what you're gonna see is that I will continue working on these links and I will assemble this whole chain. So let's go. First step, prepare the flux. I'm going to re-grind out some with my little tiny cone here. Because it is kind of chunky. So you just grind it out. It is also knocking off some that is already on there. So I'm grinding the old and grinding new. Add on your distilled water. Stir. Add some more distilled water. Looks. Get some solder chips ready. So for this video, I think I will be okay soldering a link and then quenching and then soldering a link and then quenching. Let's see how it goes. So right here, I have enough chain to hang over the edge, so I'm gonna do that because it's working pretty well. That is not what I want the solder to do, or the flux, so what I will do is rinse it. So I rinsed off the flux. I make sure my rings that are done have the solder joint facing away from the ring. Now I will start again. Dry your chain off too. That way your flux won't run down your links. So, as you can see, in not a very long amount of time, I have a nice little chain going on. And I still have 2, 4, 6, 7 more sets to solder up. So if you find that your chain is pulling on your jump ring, this bring it off the edge and pile it next to it. I like to set my chain up like this when I am soldering on it, because you have a portion going over the side and then the part going away that's new. And the chain will pretty much hold itself there, so you can angle your fire this way and not heat up anything else on here. Forgot the flux. Usually your chain, you just drop it into a paper towel and then squeeze it. It'll dry it off pretty instantly. So now I'm gonna put this chain aside. And I'm gonna work on these chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then I'll add that to this and you'll see how quickly you can build a chain. So if you made it this far, as you can tell, I have a pretty long chain. So if I was to take this piece that I already have and solder it together, I will have a necklace. So I've already made this bracelet just to like, I made the bracelet to show myself that it is possible to make a bracelet using this style of link and making all the links yourself. So at this point, the chain is really heavy, so I'm going to stretch it over both sides. I have one last solder piece that's ready to go. And this one, I'll just dangle it all over the edge on one side. So for your own work, you don't have to use a clasp. You can just make your chain. You will want to have it oriented all in the same direction as the chain is supposed to flow, so your links will crisscross and lay nice and perfectly flat. Then you can line up your other end and have a seamless chain. So, now I will go through and check all of my links that are not stretched. your link is weak, it will likely break right away as soon as you apply pressure. And there you have it. This is a paperclip chain made out of 16 gauge wire that I made from ingots on my DIY wire pulling setup. I will go ahead and pickle this, and I will see you in the next video where it's all clean. Thanks for watching.